Hi, we are going to see how to convert this tabular data into this amazing interactive visual. This is done using Power BI Timeline Storyteller Visual. By the way, I am Dr. Nitin. My passion is to make people more efficient. I have coached more than 400,000 people worldwide, but that's not enough. 1 billion people use these tools and I want to reach all of them. Let's start with adding the timeline visual. It's not there by default, so you go to Insert, Visual, More Visuals from App Source and install the visual. Now let's insert the visual on the canvas. Visual Gallery, scroll down, find the Timeline Storyteller visual, insert it. Before we go ahead, let's understand our data. Each row is a video I have published. So I have the date of publishing, title of the video, the topic of the video, and the category. That means whether it is a short or long video. It is designed for showing things which happened across time. That's why it's called a timeline visual. So let's start with the simplest thing. The date, end date is important. So I'm going to put it as the publishing date. Then I want the text, content text, which is the title. I have multiple topics. Those are called facets. So I'm going to choose product as the facet. If I want to, I have category as well, another kind of classification. In my case, I'm going to use it as video type, long or short. Remember, your facet and category can be the same. So I want to keep track of when did I start creating, when did I actually publish. It is just to explain how start and end date is rendered here. While I'm doing all this, the visual is automatically showing the data like a Gantt chart. So this is the timeline visual in action. Before we do anything else, let's look at the formatting. So either right click on this and click format, or click on this paintbrush and say more options. The only option which is interesting is go to display and increase this UI scale depending on your monitor resolution. I'm going to increase it to 1.2. Close the format, close build a visual. Now everything we need to do will happen within the visual. So the visual has its own menus. On the top is the main toolbar. At the bottom is the storytelling toolbar. And on the left side, there is formatting toolbar, three toolbars. Currently, my category is video type. There are only two types, long and short, and those have become a legend, long and short. It automatically does color coding. Now I'm thinking I don't want color coding to happen based on long or short. I want it to happen by product. So I'm going to remove this category and put product there. Now my category is also product. Facet is also product. Because product is a category, it created color coding for that purpose. And it also shows me the legend. The legend also has a purpose. It's interactive. So if I want to show what I have done with PowerPoint, just hover there. It'll highlight only the PowerPoint portion. That's where the interactivity is. If I hover away, then all the colors are shown. Notice that the legend occupies space and it is overlapping on my main chart. So you can collapse it from here. The next step is to understand the concept of visual storytelling for timelines. So first I'm going to start with the overall picture. And I want to record that picture as a snapshot or a slide. That's the record scene button. Click on it. It'll create a snapshot here. The next step in my storytelling is maybe I want to only show things which are related to Excel. Now I go to filter. There are multiple types of filter. We have hide and emphasize. We have category based filter, facet based filter, and segment based filter. So I'm going to click on Excel. And let's save it as another snapshot. Like this, you create multiple snapshots and build the story. The most powerful part here is how to represent time. Currently, we are showing it in linear format and in chronological order. And there is only one timeline. That's the default. We can change it. I have facet. Facet is product. I want to show it by product. Click on facet. Now the same timeline gets divided for each product. And I can see that for forms, I have not done much. OneDrive, not much. PowerPoint, yes. Power BI, yes. And so on. Segments is also like facets, but segments are based on time. So my data was approximately 3 months of data. So it has one for September, one for October, November, December, like that. So facet by time is called segment. So linear, chronological, and all three layouts we have seen. Let's come back to the default. Now, when the timeline is very long, hundreds of years, thousands of years, then you should use a logarithmic scale. So even though the duration is very, very long, it still fits on the screen. Otherwise, so large time durations, use log scale. Sequential is like chronological, but in chronological, if there was no activity, there'll be a gap. Whereas in sequential, it's just one after another. It doesn't bother about time at all. So I'm going to show it faceted. Now it is going to show me all the items here, and Excel this many. It's like a bar chart. The another way of representing the timeline is in a radial manner. This is how the radial version looks. Same thing, but the timeline is now curved. I can have simple unified or faceted, in which case I'll have multiple such sort of timelines next to each other. So this is for OneDrive, this is for Outlook, and so on and so forth. And segmented will be one for each month in this case. So depending on the duration, start date and end date of your time, it will decide how many segments it needs. Let's come back to the default. I'm sure you'll notice that some of these buttons are inactive. Why is that? Because those become active only under very specific circumstances. For example, when I have linear and I have segmented, the calendar comes into picture. If I click on calendar, it actually shows a calendar view, and then all the data migrates into the calendar. Let's create a snapshot for this view as well. Now come back to default. If linear and sequential is on and it is in unified mode, then you get spiral. It's an interesting way of showing things. It doesn't show you any dates or data. It's just another way of representing things. Keep the legend on and keep it near the actual spiral. Another interesting way is curve, where you can actually draw any shape and it will arrange your data around this. So I'm going to draw a shape in the character C form, and now it arranged everything around it. It's just a fun way of looking at the same data. Here is another representation which is called collapsed. It is like sequential. So in between these two, there was a long gap, and that gap is represented here. If there is nothing here, that means there was no gap. They were next to each other in chronological terms. So this is a combination of sequential and chronological. So let's take a snapshot of this as well. The radial representation is very commonly used in time-oriented infographics. So if I want to emphasize on certain events, you click on them. If you right-click on it and leave it alone, this will stay. And now I create a snapshot. In addition, I can put annotation text as well. I can also put images either from a URL or from local drive. It will resize the image and put it. Because this is a circular kind of visual, it's automatically cropped in this shape. I'll take one more snapshot for this. So now we have built our story and we want to present it. So make sure you're on the first slide, go to playback mode, and then you can go to the next slide or previous slide. Between slides, all the data points will migrate. Also notice that our annotation and the items which we had enabled are still there. What it should not be used for is any kind of quantity based data. For example, if I wanted to show number of views for every video, this is not the visual, because as you can see here, it doesn't have any place to show quantifiable information. It's category based information with date being the focus. I'm sure you found this useful. So when you like, share, subscribe, YouTube will show this to more and more people, and everyone benefits in the process. Before you go, have a look at another visual called Sand Dance. I'm sure you'll love it. So that's it for now. See you next time. Take care.